Good morning children, welcome to math session. Now children, we finish our yesterday session with chapter number 13, division part 1, okay? Today we will be doing chapter number 13, division part 2, okay? Now children, topic today we will learn how to divide, okay? Yesterday we learned that what is division, how we are going to share equally in division, how we can form lots or groups in division. Today we will learn how we are going to divide. What is division? Division means distributing things equally. What is division, children? Division means distributing things equally. Division means making equal group of things. Now in our previous session, I taught you how you are distributing things equally, and I taught you how you will make equal group of things, okay? Today I will be teaching you how you are going to divide it in a mathematic way. Now the sign for division is, wait, okay, so the sign for division is this one, okay? See, there will be one sleeping line and two dots, one below the other. This is the sign for division. Okay, now next, for example, now see on the screen, you can see it is written 15, then the division sign is there and it is written 3 equal to number 5. How you will read it? It is read as 15 divided by 3 is equal to 5. How it is read as 15, this, that is this, divided by 3 is equal to 5. We can use tables to carry out division without taking objects. Now we can use tables also if we want to carry out a division without taking out any objects. Okay, let us see how. Now for example, you need to carry out the division 27 divided by 3. Now what you will do, you will say the table of 3, okay, up to 27, till where you get 27. Now if I say the table of 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, 3 sixes are 18, 3 sevens are 21, 3 eights are 24, 3 nines are 27. So I got my answer 27. How much? 3 nines are 27. So when we divide 27 divided by 3, we get our answer 9. So now we didn't divide it here. We just said the table of 3 up to 27. We got our answer 9. Understood? Now next. Now to carry out the division, 64 divided by 8. What we will do? We will say the table of 8 times table up to 64, we will say. Okay, 8 ones are 8. Where the number 64 comes, we have to end our table. Okay, 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40, 8 sixes are 48, 8 sevens are 56, 8 eights are 64. Understood? How much? 8 eights are 64. We got our answer 64. So 64 divided by 8 will be 8. Now let us move to the next. Now divide 6 divided by 2. Now here we will need to divide. Okay. So I will divide. Wait. Okay. So what I will do? The number which is smaller, that is number 2, I will write under the inside the bracket. Number 6, I will write it here. Okay, the bigger number will be inside and the smaller number will be outside. Now you are going to say the table of 2 till you get your answer 6. 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. So 2 threes are 6. So 3 you are going to write up, 6 down, below 6, and 6 minus 6 will be 0. Now children, this 3 which you got the answer is known as quotient. Q-U-O-T-I-E-N-T. This is your quotient. The number 6, okay, from which your dividing that bigger number, that is known as a dividend. Okay, I'm not having place here, children. I'll show you in the next slide. Okay, and the number 0 is known as a remainder. R-E-M-A-I-N-D-E-R. The number 2 is known as divisor. D-I-V-I-S-O-R. Okay. So number 3, the answer which we got is known as quotient. 6 is known as dividend. 0 is known as remainder. And 2 is known as a divisor. Show you. Now the number to be divided. Okay, the number to be divided is the dividend. Okay, which number is to be divided? Number 6. So that is our dividend. The number by which we divide, was 2. So 2 is the divisor. Okay, and the answer which remains is known as remainder, and on the top it is known as quotient. We will solve the next sum, that is 36 divided by 9. Okay. So what I will do, 9 I will write here, 36, that is a bigger number, I will write it inside. So I will say the table of 9 till I get the number 36. 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27, 9 fours are 36. So what I will write, 9 fours are 36. Okay, where I will write that 4, in tens place. Yes, 9 fours are 36. Okay, so now minus. Now 6 minus 6 will be 0, 3 minus 3 will be 0. So 4 is your what? Quotient. I am not having children here place, so I am writing only Q. 0 is your remainder, 36 is your dividend, 9 is your divisor. Understood, children, how you are going to divide? 4 is your quotient, D is your dividend, that is 36, R remainder, that is 0, and D 9 is your divisor. Okay, 12 divided by 4. How you are going to divide? First you will put a sign of division. You are going to write 4 outside, 12 inside. Now 4 table you have to say till you get your answer 12. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12. So you will write 3 minus 12. Okay, 0, 2 minus 2 will be 0, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So 3 is what? Quotient. 12 is what? Dividend. 0 is what? Remainder. 4 is what? Divisor. Understood, children? What answer you are getting if you divide 12 multiplied by 4? 12 divided by 4? Answer 3. Okay? 22 divided by 5. Let us divide 5 and 22. Okay? Now, table of 5 till 22. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25. Now 5 fives are 25 is bigger than 22. So a bigger number cannot be subtracted from a smaller. From 22, we cannot subtract 25, correct? So what we will do, we will take 5 fours are, because from 22 we can subtract 20. So we will take 5 fours are 20. So I will write 5 fours are and I will write 20. Okay, now I will subtract. 2 minus 0 will be 2. 2 minus 2 will be 0. So what is my quotient? My quotient is 4. And what is my remainder? My remainder is, just a sec, my remainder is 2. What is my dividend? 22. What is my divisor? 5. Understood? So if I divide 22 divided by 5, I get my quotient 4, I get my remainder 2. 15 divided by 5. Let us divide 5 and 15. Now we'll say the table of 5 till we get our answer 15. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15. So we are getting our answer 3. 5 threes are 15. Subtract. 5 minus 5 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. So what is our quotient? Quotient is 3. What is our answer? Remainder 0. What is our dividend? Wait. What is our dividend? 15. What is our divisor? 5. Okay. 3 is our quotient. 15 is our dividend. Remainder is 0. And 5 is our divisor. Let us subtract next. 7, 42. Okay. Now we'll say the table of 7 till we get our answer 42. 7 ones are 7. 7 twos are 14. 7 threes are 21. 7 fours are 28. 7 fives are 35. 7 sixes are 42. So we'll write 6. 7 sixes are 42. Now 2 minus 2 is 0. 4 minus 4 is 0. So 6 is our quotient. 7 is our divisor. 42 is our dividend. And 0 is our remainder. Understood, children? 6 is our quotient, 42 is our dividend, 0 is our remainder, and 7 is our divisor. Next, 54 divided by 6. 6 smaller number will be always outside and bigger number will be inside. Now we'll say the table of 6 till we get our 54. 6 into divided by 54. Now we'll say the table of 6. 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 6 threes are 18. 6 fours are 24. 6 fives are 30. 6 sixes are 36. 6 sevens are 42. 6 eights are 48. 6 nines are 54. So we are getting 6 9s are 54. We'll subtract. 4 minus 4 will be 0. 5 minus 5 will be 0. Okay. So 9 will be our quotient. 54 will be our dividend. 0 will be our remainder. And 6 will be our divisor. Okay. Now 64 divided by 8. Let us subtract. Let us divide 8 and 64. So we'll say the table of 8 till we get our answer 64. 8 ones are 8. 8 twos are 16. 8 threes are 24. 8 fours are 32. 8 fives are 40. 8 sixes are 48. 8 sevens are 56. 8 8s are 64. 8 8s are 64. 4 minus 4 will be 0. 6 minus 6 will be 0. So 8 will be our quotient. 64 dividend. 0 remainder. 8 divisor. Understood? 47 divided by 5. 5 and 47. Smaller number will be outside, bigger number will be inside. Okay. Now we will say the table of 5 till we get our answer 47. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25, 5 sixes are 30, 5 sevens are 35, 5 eights are 40, 5 nines are 45, 5 tens are 50. Now 50 is a bigger number than 47, so it cannot be subtracted. So we'll take a smaller number, that is 5 nines are, okay, 45. Now 45 is a smaller number, so we can easily subtract. 7 minus 5 will be 2. 4 minus 4 will be 0. So 9 will be your quotient. Okay. 9 will be your quotient. And 47 will be your dividend. 2 will be your remainder. Okay. And 5 will be your divisor. Understood? So with this, children, we finish our today's session of division part 2. And you learn today how you can divide. Now what you are going to do, children, this. Now in yesterday's session I told you, you are not going to write anything because it was not needed. But today you have to write this, children, in your notebook. You are going to write today's date. Okay, first write today's date. Then you are going to write, wait, I'll show you. Then you are going to write chapter number 13, division. Okay, no need to write part 1, part 2. Only write chapter number 13, division, and write today's date. Okay, after giving the heading and after writing the date, you are not going to write topic. Okay, this all, children, nothing you are going to write. This was an explanation for you. You are going to directly start with your sums. I'll show you from where. And children, I'm going to check in this Friday's session. So you have to be, your book should be ready, okay? So you're going to write this as the first question, that is divide 6 divided by 2. This will be your first question and then you will solve that question, okay? After you solved, then don't write this, okay? Then you're going to write the second question, then solve it. Then the third, fourth, but in one page, try to solve only two sums. On one page, two sums, not more than that. It will look very dirty and messy if you write 3 to 4 sums in one page. Okay, after you have written all the sums, till the last, where I'll show you, till where you are going to write, you are going to write till 47 divided by 5. This will be your last sum. Okay, children, so till then, you keep practicing and keep learning. See you in the next session. Bye. Take care. See you soon.